Hey, church family. My name is Annie Neufeld. I'm the pastor of small groups here at Lake Avenue Church, and this is your weekly small groups video. This past weekend, Pastor Matthew John preached on John chapter 21, and in this passage, Peter decides to go fishing. After abandoning and betraying Jesus, after the humiliation and suffering of the cross, Peter and the other disciples decide to do something that they know how to do. They decide to go fishing. So they get in their boat, they're trying to catch fish, trying to do something purposeful and meaningful in all the confusion and all the loss. But to add insult to injury, they go out there and they don't catch anything. Then though, the storyteller tells us that someone from the shore yells out to them and tells them to put out their nets on the right side of the boat. And for some reason, they listen to this strange person. And when they do, they catch so many fish that they can't even pull them into the boat. At this point, John recognizes this stranger as Jesus, and Peter decides to jump out of the boat in all of his without any inhibitions, with all of his boldness. He jumps into the boat, he swims to the shore, and he finds Jesus. And eventually, the rest of the disciples come with this boatload of fish, and they join Jesus for breakfast with fish and bread. And this was just one of the many resurrection appearances of Jesus at this point in time. Now, this is a well-known story, but Pastor Matthew gave us a new lens through which to see it and understand it. Pastor Matthew talked about Peter being in a time loop in this passage, that he is walking this well-worn path. He was in a cycle of repeated patterns, kind of like deja vu or the movie Groundhog Day. This wasn't the first time that Peter had gone fishing. This wasn't the first time that he had been unsuccessful at fishing. This wasn't the first time that he had encountered Jesus while he was on the water. This was a well-worn path. And we also can get into this sort of time loop in our lives, doing the same thing over and over and over again, hoping for a new result, but just experiencing the same old, same old. Pastor Matthew said that what broke the time loop was when Peter encountered something that existed outside of time, when Peter saw someone who transcended time, and that was Jesus. The risen Jesus looked different from the way that he had looked in his physical body before he died, but Peter was able to recognize the familiar voice of God in this unfamiliar form of the risen Jesus. And that's what we're called to do as well, to discern this familiar voice of God in unfamiliar places. So that's our discussion prompt for this week, to talk about a time when you recognize that familiar voice of God in an unfamiliar place. Maybe it was through a movie, maybe through a book, maybe through a broken relationship or somewhere in the culture around you where you weren't expecting to see God, but you did. When did you hear the voice of the Spirit in an unexpected place? I know this happened for me the other day through skateboarding. My daughter and I were on a walk, and while we were walking in one of the cul-de-sacs, we saw some teenage boys who were skateboarding, who were honing their craft. They were working on their jumps and their flips and all sorts of cool things. And my daughter is not shy, so she sat down on the curb and she started cheering them on. Now, at first, I think this surprised the boys, but eventually they started interacting with her. And at one point, one of the boys came up to her and said, "You know, I have a little kid skateboard. Do you want me to go get it and you can join us?" And her face beamed, her eyes lit up, and we had to say yes. So we put a helmet on her and she started skateboarding too. And the boys started cheering for her like she was a pro. At the end, the boy said, "You can have this skateboard." And that could have been just a fun moment in our day. But I really saw it as a reminder that God was present with us in this world where we are more likely to see scarcity than plenty. This was a reminder that our God is generous and that he longs to give us joy and wonder, that he has planted joy and wonder everywhere in the world around us. So let's talk about a time when you have experienced God, the familiar voice of God, in an unfamiliar or unexpected place. And then where might we need to listen for that voice, for that familiar voice in unexpected places in the world around us today? Well, church family, this weekend we sang, "Our God cannot be moved. Our God will never change. Our God will reign forevermore." But this God, who cannot be moved, is indeed on the move in an ever-changing world and is inviting us to join him in his kingdom work. So let's jump into the water, even when it's scary. Let's join him. Go in peace.